Thanks.
Hi. When can I start?
Okay, go ahead, Mike.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'd like to start out by saying that, you know, I like to set myself or set a higher standard for myself, a higher standard of conduct, a higher standard of work ethic, a higher standard of being a father and a husband. And, you know, I expect a lot from my players as well. I say the same things to them when I coach them. We talk a lot about setting high standards for yourself, whether in preparation or in performance. My wife and I raise our children this way in terms of, you know, representing our name, our last name, and what that means, and remember who you are. And in this regard, in this situation, with my comment, I've failed. I didn't just go below the bar, I went way below the bar. You know, I made a mistake. I was wrong. I brought a lot of undue attention to the Minnesota Vikings organization. I brought an unwanted distraction. And, you know, I apologize. The apology that I spoke about that I put out on Friday, I want to reiterate that in a very humble and sincere manner. It's very much, you know, I still stand by that. And now I'd like to move on. I'd like to move on to the 2014 Minnesota Vikings and what this season has to offer for us.
What did you regret the most about the whole efforts over there?
You know, the biggest thing I regret is that I brought a lot of bad publicity to the Minnesota Vikings, and I felt like I let my my family down.
Do you, in hindsight, wish you just said what you said in the second interview right away and said the truth or whatever?
Well, I spoke to the appropriate individuals, and I cooperated throughout this entire process. And, you know, the results are in that investigation, and now I think it's time to move on.
Just to be clear, you had nothing to do. You don't make decisions in terms of personnel, or cutting, or keeping Chris Clear or anybody else.
That's correct. I don't make final decisions. That's up to our general manager and our head coach, and all I do is make recommendations.
Clearly, has said you made more than one homophobic remark. Did you make more than one, or did you just make one?
At the end of the day, and I appreciate that question, I understand where you're coming from, but I did speak to the appropriate individuals. I've cooperated fully from the very beginning of this investigation, and I've told them everything I need to tell them.
Did you feel the 3-game suspension was fair or warranted?
You know, it's something that I respect. It's a decision I respect, and it's one that I obviously accept, and that's one I will fulfill.
Do you think it'll be easy within the framework of the team to just move on because they know you so well?
Well, you know, you'll have to ask that players, but I think we've had something that I'm not brand new. The good thing, I've been here 3 years. There's a great 3-year foundation of our special teams here, and I believe that our players really believe in what we're doing. You know, I feel bad for them that I won't be here for 2 weeks or 3 weeks, you know, probably 3 weeks, and that's what hurts, that I won't be with them. And, you know, at the end of the day, that's the hard part for me with the suspension.
Mike, if the team made the full report public, is that something you would want?
You know, I haven't seen the full report. I wouldn't know.
Mike, do you feel like you need to do anything to rebuild credibility of either the players, the organization, the community?
Well, I hope to be doing that right now, Murph. You know, you understand. I'm doing that now because I came out with that apology on Friday, and I sincerely mean it. I know I've let some people down. I know I've embarrassed the organization a little bit, and that's something that obviously the worst thing for me. I believe that throughout the entire spring and the off season, I thought we had a great off season. The guys worked hard. They believe in what we're doing. We have, you know, working with a bunch of new players, and they're buying into what we're doing. It's an exciting time for Minnesota Viking football. That's why I want this distraction hopefully behind us, and that we can move forward and on to a great season this year.
You said it's the way you have a relationship with players. I mean, because obviously you said something you might say to, you know, a group of guys around the campfire drinking beers. I mean, this is a little bit different now.
Well, I'm not going to change the way I coach, and I'm not going to change the way I teach, but I've learned a lesson. I have learned a lesson here. That's the great thing about this situation. I'm going to look back and say, you know what, something's good. God, it has to come from this, and that's going to be it. That I learned a hard lesson that, you know, I've got to be sensitive to other people in what I say, and that's not going to happen again.
Why did you say you think it'll probably be 3 weeks versus 2 with cut to 2?
It's at 3 weeks right now. I made a mistake. It's at 3 weeks right now.
Okay, but is there a chance if you complete sensitivity training it could go to 2?
Yes.
And what are the chances? What does that entail, and what do you have to do to get it to 2?
I have not been told that, but I do. I'm going to take that sensitivity training, I believe, the first week of the season. I won't be, obviously, can't go to the office for 3 weeks and can't be around my guys for 3 weeks. So I will take the training, and then we'll go from there.
It lasts a week?
The training?
Yeah.
I'm not familiar.
Do you know where you go or what you do?
No,
or?
Sir. I don't know. Okay. I don't know all the details yet.
Mike, how's the team set up to go on without you for 2 or 3 weeks?
You know, that's something that I know Coach Zimmer and Rick are working on right now, and I don't know the details, Mark.
But when you're coaching on the field, do you have someone, like an assistant that kind of...
My assistant, Ryan Ficken, does a great job for me. He's an outstanding young coach, you know, he'd be fully prepared to do it if need be. If they feel like they need to bring in someone with more experience, then so be it. But I know that our foundation will be set up, and that whoever comes in to help bridge that gap for 3 weeks, they're not going to change what we're doing. We're going to keep going with what I've taught and what I've done here for the past 3.5 years.
What will you do with those 2 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks?
1 week is, I know, at least 1 week is going to be the training, the sensitivity training, and from there, I don't know, drive myself crazy.
Mike, when did you address the situation with Mike Zimmer? I guess when did you tell him what you said, and what kind of conversations did you guys have?
You know, the conversations between the head coach and I would like to keep them private, but we've been talking about this situation since, when I was interviewed, essentially, to be rehired here.
Were you concerned about losing your job during that point?
That's a great question. I figured out a long time ago that I can only control what I can control, and the rest of it, I'll go batty if I think about it all the time. So I tried not to think about it, and then just came out every day and did my job.
Last couple for Mike.
How do you sell yourself, just like the other assistants who stayed, to Mike, like he's putting together the staff?
How did I sell myself?
Yeah.
I went in there and, talked about the success we've had. Some of the failures that we've had on the field, the things that we need to improve upon. Talked to him a lot about personnel, talked a lot about my philosophy on special teams, and a lot of it matches Coach Zimmer's, and I was hope that's one of the reasons why he hired me.
Do you think you owe Chris Cleary any personal apology, and is there any plan to reach out to him?
My focus is, Chris has totally been on getting ready for the season and the 90 guys we got coming to camp, and I'm really excited about this new season.
What's
the support like from the players on the team now? If they come here, do you feel like they're on your side?
They've been great. From the Will family to Rick Spielman to Coach Zimmer, our coaching staff, all 90 players. And the new young guys really don't know a whole lot about the situation, but the veterans that are here, I know they have my back. They've been giving me great support. They realize I've made a mistake. They know this does not define who Mike Priefer is as a man or as a football coach, and I think they're ready to move on.
All right. Thanks.
Thank you, guys.